And I believe that. And so that's why I got my master's at Tribeca. I've always dreamed of counseling with military families, and Tribeca is one of two programs that are accredited for the MFT program. I'm entering my PhD now in clinical counseling, and already I'm seeing that hard work pay off.
Write your own story at Tribeca Nazarene University. Visit tnustarthere.org for more information.
Back here at the Trojan Fieldhouse, Clayton Coffin joined with Haley Felker, the junior from Kingston Springs. Haley, we just said it a moment ago, 17 of 21 shooting these last three games. What have you been feeling out there to provide a spark for our team offensively?
I don't know. These past few games, it's been fun to play with, you know. I have to give credit to my teammates, though. I mean, I wouldn't be able to make a single shot without all those assists from them. So it's been the past few games. It's been really fun.
And the three-point line has been very favorable. We saw 4-for-4 against Regis, you know, a couple games ago, now 5-for-5. You're the first player in Tribeca history to do that. How does that make you feel to go, you know, just light it up from downtown, which is something to see?
That's exciting. Last year I struggled a little bit, and, you know, coming off the season beginner, I was hurt. So it's been really – I've really enjoyed coming out and being able to play, and I feel like, you know, helping my teammates a lot. So it's been really fun.
These last two games, obviously two big conference wins in the fall before we, you know, get into the new year. But how important was it for us to come out and kind of establish that, you know, we're still kind of the team to beat, and you're going to have to come into our place and play us well to have a chance?
Yeah, it's been really good for us to come out here these past two first games. You know, we were ranked to win second, you know, and that was hard on us because we won last year.
Right.
So, you know, put a little chip on our shoulders. We wanted to be first. So I think we've come out here these past two games and proved that we're a team to beat. So we're going to keep that up.
What did you think of our inside play? I mean, Sarah Raby is getting progressively better, and Anna, she's solid. What do you think of our inside play? And if we can get that going with our shooting along the outside, I think we're going to be very tough to beat going forward.
Yes, our post players have put on a show the past few games. They're so strong inside. Sarah and Anna both. I mean, I know when I give it to them, you know, hey, I'm heading back for defense because they're either going to put it up or get a foul. I mean, they've played amazing, and, you know, we just keep giving it to them.
Haley, we had a rough time against the University of Indianapolis last year up at their place, and that's who we're going to play next. Looking back at last year, not obviously the outcome we wanted, but they're going to come here now. Looking back on last year, what do we have to do in your mind? I know it's a new game and we got to put it together, but what do you think we got to do to come away with a good win against a pretty good team?
Last year I think we had a lot of turnovers. I think we need to watch our turnovers and defense. I mean, play defense, keep them stopped, and, you know, watch our passes and, like I said, establish the post game and go up strong.
Haley, I want to thank you for your time. Congrats on the win. We'll see you later.
Thank you so much.
That was Haley Felker. She goes 7-of-7 from the field, 5-of-5 from downtown, and 4-of-4 at the free throw line. 23 points, 4 rebounds for Haley. She also had 3 assists, 2 blocks, and 4 steals. Quite a stat line right there for Miss Felker. Let's go over the final stats, and then we'll wrap this one up. The Trojans win 99-58. In the game, they shoot 58.6% from the field. They were 34-of-58 from the field. They were 8-of-19 from downtown, a 42% clip there. And at the foul line, they were 23-of-25, 92%. 23 for Felker, 17 for Casey Britt Bell, which matches a season high. She was 6-of-9 from the field, 2-of-4 from downtown, and 3-of-3 at the foul line. She also had a team high and a game high, 8 rebounds to go with 3 assists and 3 steals. 13 points off the bench for Kylie White on 5-of-9 shooting. That's back-to-back games for Kylie in double-figure scoring off the bench. She also had 3 rebounds. 9 points each for Marissa Jennings and Anna Mitchell. Jennings was 4-of-5 from the field, and Anna Mitchell also grabbed 5 rebounds. Rounding out the scoring, 8 for Sarah Raby on 4-of-4 shooting, and 7 for Christina Kirtner. She was 3-of-3 at the foul line. She also had 9 assists to just 3 turnovers, 3-to-1 ratio there, pretty good. The Trojans in the game outscore Ohio Valley 46-10 in the paint. They converted 27 Ohio Valley turnovers into 35 points. They also had an 11-10 second chance points advantage. On the flip side for Ohio Valley, they shoot 19-of-58 from the field. That's 32.8%. But remember, in the first half, they were 3-of-23, a 13% clip right there. And that allowed the Trojans to jump out at least to a 37-2 lead. Leading scorer, 20 for Megan Miller off the bench on 7-of-15 shooting. She was 4-of-7 from downtown and 2-of-4 at the foul line. 10 points for Amy Brooks, also off the bench. She was 4-of-7 from the field and hit a pair of three-point shots. Leading rebounder was Kayla Parsley with 7 to go along with 5 points. 9 points for Shelby Way on 4-of-6 shooting from the foul line. And rounding out the scoring, 5. Oh, we said that. Kayla Parsley with 5. Those are your final statistics, folks. We got about 18 minutes to go until the start of the men's game. Greg Ruff will have the call that one. Hope you enjoy it. We're going to take a timeout, and we'll come back right after this.
Hi, I'm Ryan Albajava at TNU. I'd like to tell you a little bit about some of our drinks here at the shop. Lattes, mochas, but I want to tell you a little bit more specifically about a particular brewing method called a pour over. What we do is we grind the beans fresh, we place them inside one of these cups here, put a filter, place the beans inside that, use really hot water, pour it over, use a little bit more coffee than what you would normally think to use. We kind of work that coffee as it's going through, and it makes a real bold, very smooth cup of coffee. If you would like to experience that cup of coffee, we are in the Center for Leadership Calling and Service. Or if you'd like to call us and get more information, our phone number is 248-1716.
I was here for the entire degree, married in my senior year, did my student teaching and got married, started in the same month, and met John in my second year here. He came to Trevecca when I was a sophomore. We had met through my boss. There was a man named Clifford Keyes, all the kids called him Pop. I would go over to the dorm to my roommate and we would just hoot about that. Oh, can you think Pop Keyes would know a guy that I would be interested in? Well, he would tell John the same thing. He said, there's a girl that works in my office you really should meet. And I guess he must have just decided to stop by Pop's office and see who this girl was.
Well, you hear about that so much, you check it out.
One thing about my time at Trevecca that impacted my story the most was how it gave me a love for education and for children and for people and just reaching out to others. If I had not come to Trevecca, I think that my life could have been very different. I definitely think coming to Trevecca had a very positive impact on my life, and I was able to be led in the direction that was right for me. I know that if I was not at Trevecca, I would not be where I am today.
I know everybody's story is a little bit different at Trevecca, and Trevecca is so many different things to everybody, but here's the deal. It has made me the person I am today. Trevecca has been one of the most important aspects and points in my life. It has set the course for my family, for career, for relationships. It's played a role in everything that has made me, me.
I think that living a great story means being surprised by your life and by how it turns out, and laughing a lot, and having people to witness that story with, and knowing that their stories are part of your story and your story are part of their stories. Being at Trevecca means I got to be part of a much longer story than my own, and it helps me make sense of my life in the context of those stories. And it's really nice to know the people who are writing the stories along with me.
We talk sometimes about, would we do things differently? I wouldn't do a thing differently. Spent my life just the way I wanted to. I wouldn't trade those years as a student, and of course as a faculty member either, for anything.
Thank you.
Hello, how are you?
I'm fine.
It's already live, but I mean...
Okay, well, just don't have my audio live until we confirm it, okay?
Okay.
All right. I need a few minutes to set up here.
Okay, I'll just turn your audio down.
All right. Well, have audio so people can hear it, but not me.
Oh.
Thank you.
I've already had my associate's degree. It worked for me. But I noticed a point in my life where I wanted more. I wanted to attain those things that I needed to get me where I wanted to be in life. Going back to school, I thought I had to take online classes or I had to commute. But Trevecca had a satellite campus right here in town. And thanks to Trevecca, I'm finding out that I'm able to do this.
Finish your degree at Trevecca Nazarene University. Visit TNUStartHere.org for more information.
Nazarene University, along with the Great Midwest Athletic Conference, encourage sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. Profanity, racial or ethnic comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or fans will not be tolerated in grounds for removal from the Trojan Fieldhouse. If you're not already doing so, please stand or remain standing. Just a moment. Jamie Dimley will lead us in the national anthem. But as we did before the women's game a couple hours ago, we're going to pause for a moment of silence on this December 7th day as we remember what happened back in 1941 in Pearl Harbor and think forward all these years, the freedoms that we've enjoyed in our country, but the price that was paid by many down through the decades who gave their lives for our freedom. Let's pause for a moment and then Jamie will lead us. Kennedy, number 32, Pulis Dombrovskis, a
the coach is Mike Snell.
Eight. Me out there. And welcome in, Greg Ruff along with you. Well, here we are. Courtside on this December 7th, the anniversary of the bombing at Pearl Harbor, which Michael Johnson over the last two games has mentioned as a moment of silence before we start the games. And it is something that we all need to remember as we go forward. Ohio Valley, the Fighting Scots in the blue uniforms, white numerals and some red trim. Trojans in the home whites, purple numerals and gold trim. It is the Trojans getting the tip. Jordan Miles was at the center jump along with Saquon Lawrence for the Fighting Scots. GMAC action, game number two here at the Trojan Fieldhouse. Feed goes into Miles. Now to Turner at the foul line. The elbow left of the lane, kicks out to Clay. Clay back to Turner. Turner now dribbles, looks inside, gets it to Clay. Clay looking in for Miles, bounce pass to him. He turns, dribbles into the lane, shoots, and he scores. Jordan Miles with the first 2 points of the basketball game. Underneath, running layup is good on the reverse side, and a foul. Saquon Lawrence, who leads Ohio Valley in scoring at 20.9 points per game, as well as 6.9 rebounds per game. He hits his first shot and will get the bonus. He is a 73% shooter from the line, 48 of 66 on the season. He is a left-hander. It is on the way, and it is good, so he gets the three-point play. They will press a lot like Salem International did on Thursday night. Trojans have got a lot of practice at that over their first nine games of the season. Sanford drives, shoots, got fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two, and that'll be two fouls on Artus Vittens.
Two shots for the Trojans, number 10, Byron Sanford.
Sanford on the year, averaging 13.2 points per game. His first free throw is on the way, and it is good. Sanford, 69% from the line on the season, 48 of 69 coming into this one. He hits both there, and the Trojans lead it 4-3. We have played less than a minute. Trojans with a man-to-man defense. As we started off, they move the ball over to Macon Jr. Now out top it goes to Vittens. Now picking up the dribble right in front of us, Parker. They back it down. Vittens in the just outside the lane. His shot is no good. Woodard gets it up ahead to Sanford for the Trojans. He puts it up. It's good, and he'll go to the line. Byron Sanford with the basket. He now has four, and he will get a bonus free throw. The foul is against Jerry Macon Jr. It is his first. It is the second against Ohio Valley. Sanford hits the free throw. He has hit all three. Trojans shot 71 free throws on Thursday night. And a near record. It was a record for the Trojans. There's a pass inside. Vittens gets it and lays it in. Trojans facing pressure, leading 7-5. Clay gets it from Sanford. Into the half court. Trapped. Has it come out of his hands. ends up in Sanford's hands. Looked like Ohio Valley was going to get the steal, but instead Sanford comes up with the loose ball. He kicks it back. Turner lines up a three. It is good. Aaron Turner with the start, getting the three. He is just shooting 17% on the year, 2 of 12 coming in. That's 3 of 13 now. He is a good three-point shooter. Nice reverse layup again by Saquon Lawrence. We are up and down the floor. Sanford in traffic, takes it, gets contact, puts it off the glass, and it's good. Byron Sanford with the penetration. Sanford now puts the Trojans up by 5, 12 to 7. Working the ball up top, Macon Jr. pulls it back. They set up the offense. Pass is almost stolen. Now they get it over to the left side. The three is on the way, and it is good. Let's see who that was. That was Saquon Lawrence. Lawrence with, was it, 7, 8 points now in the first half. There's a runner in the paint. It's good by Byron Sanford. It's been Lawrence and Sanford much of the way for both teams. Sanford now with 9. There's a miss. Vittens gets the rebound, puts it back up. Turner with the loose ball rebound after the second miss. Now Clay with it up the court. Clay, left wing. Trapped, bounce pass back out to Turner. Turner, right side, Sanford. Wide, open for three. It is no good. Rebound, fought for and taken away by the Scots. Up ahead with the ball. That is Parker in the lane. Puts it up. It is no good, but he's fouled. And he will get the bonus shot.
Foul is called on the shot.
The foul is against Clay. It is his first. It is 14-10 Trojans. Free throw is off the front of the iron. No good for Parker. He is a 67% shooter on the year. Just 6 of 9 coming in. He hits the second. So he is now 7 of 11 from the line on the season. Trojans face pressure, leading by 3. Clay with it. Pulls up just short of the line. Almost had his pass stolen, but Sanford gets it. Gets it up ahead. It is Woodard penetrating down the left baseline, but lost it. And now we've got a double dribble called on the Scots. OVU out of Vienna, West Virginia. Founded as a Church of Christ university by folks from Harding University over in Arkansas who found themselves in West Virginia. Church of Christ, the same thing as Lipscomb University and Harding University, Fried Hardeman University, that the Trojans have played over the years. Turner gets it right side to Sanford. Out top it goes to Woodard. Left side, that's Clay underneath the Turner. Turner turns, drives along the baseline, puts it up, no good. Sanford tips it up, but he is fouled on the miss, and I believe he's going to get 2 shots. It's going to be called against Jerry Macon Jr. That is 2 on him. And so Byron Sanford will go to the line where he has been already for 3 shots here in the first half. He'll get another. It is on the way. That one is no good, his first miss. Sanford, a sophomore out of Louisville, Kentucky, and Eastern High School. 6 foot, 175 pounder. He'll get another. Started, I believe, every game in a Trojan uniform so far. And he hits there. He did not play basketball the last couple of years while attending the University of Kentucky and decided to come down here and play with the help of Josh Pittman, the assistant coach for the Trojans this season. Out top, Ohio Valley with the ball. Trojans leading it 15-11. In the corner, 3 on the way. It is short. That was Parker. Rebound comes away to Jordan Bedwell, who checked in for the Trojans, along with Matt Pond and Christopher Elliott. Sanford still in there along with Woodard. Underneath, Pond, kick out, Bedwell in the corner, Elliott. Elliott drives towards the lane. Now Woodard slashes left of the lane. Layup is good. David Woodard with great penetration along that left side of the lane and put it off the glass with the left hand, and it's 17-11. Trojans on top of OVU. Second GMAC game of the year for both of these teams. Women won earlier tonight. Ball comes loose. Bedwell has it, and then he is fouled. And that will be the 4th team foul against OVU, and we've got the media timeout. At the first media timeout, it is the Trojans 17, OVU 11.
Hi, I'm Ryan Albajava at TNU. I'd like to tell you a little bit about some of our drinks here at the shop. Lattes, mochas, but I want to tell you a little bit more specifically about a particular brewing method called a pour over. What we do is we grind the beans fresh, we place them inside one of these cups here, put a filter, place the beans inside that, use really hot water, pour it over, use a little bit more coffee than what you would normally think to use. We kind of work that coffee as it's going through, and it makes a real bold, very smooth cup of coffee. If you would like to experience that cup of coffee, we are in the Center for Leadership Calling and Service. Or if you'd like to call us and get more information, our phone number is 248-1716.
Welcome in. Greg Ruff along with you. Trojans off to a hot start. 6 of 8 from the field, 1 of 2 from three-point range, and 4 of 5 from the foul line. Out-rebounding OVU, 4-2. OVU shooting pretty well. 4 of 8 from the field, 1 of 2 from three, 2 of 3 from the free throw line. That's why we have this game at 17-11. Trojans with just a little more opportunities with the extra rebounds and a few more free throws. Sanford gets it up ahead to Pond. Pond and the Trojans break the press, and then Pond throws it away, coming back out of the baseline. Woodard goes up for the block, and OVU comes back with it, and now we've got a foul, and we've got some shoving going on underneath there, and the officials quickly step in and break it up. Foul is going to be on Byron Sanford. That'll be his first. And going to the line will be Saquon Lawrence. Free throw on the way is short by Lawrence. He is 1 for 2 now. 8 points for him. He's out of Seat Pleasant, Maryland. The second one is no good. The loose rebound ends up in the hands of Bedwell, who had it touched first. And now the Trojans up ahead, over to Elliott. He was open for three, but drives instead. A little floater is up, no good. Came off the iron, just a little bit short. Lawrence, by the way, out of a transfer out of BYU Hawaii. OVU with the ball. New into the game for them, Gerald McDonald, number 30, and also Dombroskis, wearing number 32. Parker kicks it over. It is stolen away. Woodard takes it from Lawrence, then takes it all the way and lays it in. David Woodard, he knows what to do on the break. Trojans lead it 19-11. OVU lost at Kentucky Wesleyan on Thursday night in their first conference game of the year. Kentucky Wesleyan women defeated Salem International earlier today in the first conference final of the day. Cedarville women in a non-conference game lost to University of Indianapolis. We'll try to get those exact scores to you a little bit later. 19-11, OVU with the ball and trailing. Sanford steals the inbound pass at 2-on-1. He takes it. He's fouled. He just missed the layup, but he'll go to the line to shoot a pair, and the foul is going to be called against Austin Parker. And I have that being his first. It is. It's their team fifth. Trojans have been whistled 4 times. And Sanford to the line again. He misses the first. He has hit 4 of 6, has 10 points already here in the first half. Sanford leads Trevecca with 35 assists and 17 steals on the season. He hits the second. Second leading scorer behind David Woodard, who averages 15.4. Second free throw good, 20-11. Trojans by 9, their largest lead. Bittens wanting the ball. And there's a three out top by Lawrence. I looked away for just a second because I need to get the pronunciation. Woodard dumps it, and what are they going to call? They're going to say 31 moved over. Vittens with his second. Sinakis into the game, number 3. There's Woodard into Bedwell. Bedwell turns, glass, rolls in. It was going to come off. I was already going no good, but it rolls in for Jordan Bedwell. That's his first two. 22-14 Trojans. drive, a tip by Bedwell, but it ends up in the Scots' hands. Now they swing it around to Lawrence. Lawrence drives. He has taken 126 shots in their first eight games, far more than anybody else on the roster, by at least 30 shots more, and then they turn the ball over, and the Trojans will get it. 22-14, Trojans by eight. Right side, Woodard. Out top, Bedwell. Hands off to Elliott. Elliott passes right side to Sanford. Sanford back out. Pond for three. No good. Rebound fought for, and it's Sanford coming up with it. He gets the rebound. Reverse layup is good by Byron Sanford. Sanford having a heck of a first half here for the Trojans. I have him with 13. That's his average. Three on the way, a foul. It's going to be called on the Trojans. We'll get three free throws for Ohio Valley. It is on Matt Pond. His first, Trojans' fifth. Each team ...24-15 is your score. Lawrence to the line. He's already been there a few times himself. He hits there. That is his fourth free throw attempt. He's hit two. He's got 12 points. Each team has a player in double figures. In fact, now Lawrence with 13, as does Byron Sanford for Trevecca. Elliott throws it up ahead. Great play by Elliott. Bedwell back to Pond. Pond lays it up and in. Great play by Christopher Elliott, who was falling out of bounds and had a defender in front of him, did not commit the charge and was able to get the ball up ahead, and the Trojans had the two-on-one break. Now Elliott tips the ball loose. They get it back. Sinakis didn't see the ball coming. I think it went off his back and then out of bounds. And so the Trojans get the ball, leading 26-17. You got somebody wanting to play with you there. Get on it. Woodard drives, puts it up. He is fouled. He'll go to the line. It'll be two shots. It's whistled against Dombrowskis, his first, and Woodard goes to the line, the left-hander, the junior out of Cross Plains, Tennessee, hits. That's his first free throw of the night. He is 64% on the year, 55 of 86 coming in, but he buries both of them there. The Trojans had an off night the other night from the foul line, and I saw several of them on Friday working on the free throws in their off time on Friday. Chris Renfro into the game for the Trojans, who lead it by 11 now, 28-17. Lawrence goes to work, drives. Runner is up, it's good, and he's fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot the bonus shot after hitting the runner. It's going to be against Jordan Bedwell. That's 15 for Lawrence here in the first half. 15 of their 14 make it 16 of 20 for Lawrence. He's got 4 of 6 from the foul line. There's a runner put up by Pond. No good. Ball tipped out. Rebound comes away to Lawrence. Lawrence on the run. Kicks it out. Three is on the way, no good. Rebound, fought for, and taken away by Smelzer, who is new into the game. And now working it up top, McDonald. McDonald drives, and that is going to be a block. That, unless Bedwell was on the line, that should have been a charge, but maybe it was. I could not see, so let me correct myself there. It's going to be on Bedwell. It'll be his second. He was set. He just, I think, was inside that half circle. Timeout on the floor. Trojans lead it by 8, 11:35 to play in the first half here on the Trojan Sports Network. Back to the line, Gerald McDonald for Ohio Valley. Uniforms look a lot like Kansas. Some of their versions of their uniforms. Red, white, and blue for the Fighting Scots. Free throw, McDonald, good. So he hit the basket, got the free throw. 64% shooter from the line on the year. Hits there. He's got three on an average of 3.5. Woodard with the ball for the Trojans. Gets underneath to Miles. He's back in. Miles backing down. Goes up with a reverse layup. Boy, he got blocked in there, I believe. And Lawrence comes up with the ball. He is clearly their best player, offense and defense. Kick out to McDonald. Now they go to the baseline, stolen away by Elliott, and then he is knocked to the floor, and he'll shoot the 1-1 down here on the other end. Lucas and Martin working our cameras up there today. It's their last day with us, unless they just missed their flight on Monday, heading back home. We appreciate our Czech Republic guys for all they've done for us over the last several months. Matt Deal up top, directing things today. Elliott, his first free throw is good, so he'll get the bonus. Elliott with his first point tonight. 77% shooter from the line on the year. 27 of 35 coming in, averaging 9.3 points per game. He's a sophomore out of Spring Hill and Nashville Central Christian. He hits both, and the Trojans lead is 30 to 23. Working it out top, McDonald, now to Lawrence. Lawrence gets a screen into the lane, puts it up, he's fouled, he'll go to the line. Trojans really trying to deny him, but he is able to slash in there and get between the bodies with his quick step and slender body, and he'll go to the line to shoot two, I believe. Is that 1-1 or two? It is two. I did not look up. Lawrence, now 6 of 8 from the line. He has 18 points. Game high, 18. Trojans have Sanford with 13. And now he's got 19, does Lawrence. Here in the first half, 19 of their 25. Trojans have 30 and a 5-point lead and the ball with 10:45 to play in the first half. Sanford brings the ball up. Passes left side to Woodard. Woodard now out top to Miles. Miles looking in, left side. Woodard drives, baseline, puts it up off the glass and good on the reverse side. Beautiful drive by Woodard. He now has 8. 32-25, 10:22 to play. Lawrence with the ball. Dribbles to the left, puts in the corner. McDonald for three, good. Gerald McDonald cuts the Trojan lead down to 4 at 32-28. 10:06 to play. Sanford tried to get it into Miles. It's knocked away. McDonald gets it back after tipping it, and then he traveled. Got caught. Give that one to Christopher Elliott, who got in the path and forced him to have to try to dump it off, and before he did, he took steps. 9:59 on the clock. Trojans by 4. Sanford brings the ball up. Elliott. They look for Miles. Bounce pass into him. Miles traveled. Trojans turn it over. Smelzer in there with the defense, a 6'8 sophomore out of Bloomery, West Virginia. Hope I'm saying that right. Hampshire High School. Averaging 3 points, 3 rebounds a game. That's Sinakis. Now Lawrence. Out top. Sanford almost got it. McDonald gets it, though. They pass it quickly in the corner. They can't not take advantage, but they do. Now get it inside. Blocked by Miles. They're going to call him for the foul. Oswaldus Gazalkas going to the line. Gazalkas. 6'7 junior out of Lithuania. goes to the line for the first time, hits. He gets one more and hits them both. The lead is two for the Trojans. Well, I've totally messed up my stat sheet here. Jordan Miles doesn't mess it up. He goes to the line, trying to get the bonus free throws here. Free throw, I should say, singular. First time to the line tonight, 75% on the year. He has four first half points. This one is up and no good. Rebound, Woodard, it goes up, missed the dunk. But he gets fouled, and he'll go to the line. Smelzer committed the previous foul. Woodard will shoot two, with the Trojans leading by four. The foul is by Sinakis. His first. Woodard hits the free throw, and will get another. He has hit three of four now as he missed the fourth. Left side with the ball. Sinakis lost it out of bounds and turns the ball over. He thought there was enough contact to call a foul. 8:52 to play. Trojans by five. OVU had cut it to two at 32-30. Out top Woodard, right side, play. Fakes the three, drives and lays it in. Beautiful, that's like a ball fake. Play action, pass in the college football or NFL ranks. Lawrence puts it up and in. He had hit so many three-pointers this year. The fake on the three, they bit on it, and he was able to just fly by for the easy layup was Clay. Elliott, hop step, puts it up. He's fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two. A foul called against. That's going to be against Sinakis, and Elliott will go to the line. Elliott, two for two from the line. Averages nine a game, has two here in the first half. His free throw is on the way and good. He will get one more. Elliott sets, shoots just a little bit short and misses that one. 38-32, Trojans by six. Lawrence. Going to draw a foul from Miles. That's two on him. We've got the media timeout. 38-32 with 7:56 to play. We're back after this timeout on the Trojan Sports Network.
I've already had my associate's degree. It worked for me. But I noticed a point in my life where I wanted more. I wanted to attain those things that I needed to get me where I wanted to be in life. Going back to school, I thought I had to take online classes or I had to commute. But Trevecca had a satellite campus right here in town. And thanks to Trevecca, I'm finding out that I'm able to do this.
Finish your degree at Trevecca Nazarene University. Visit TNUStartHere.org for more information.
As we look at the stats, 7:56 to play in the first half, a little more than halfway through the first half. The Trojans lead at 38-32. They are shooting 68% from the field, 13 of 19, 1 of 3 from 3, 11 of 16 from the foul line for 69%. OVU is out-rebounding Trevecca, 10 to 7. OVU, 9 of 16 from the field, 56%, 3 of 5 from three-point range. They're hitting 11 of 14 from the foul line for 78%. Turnovers, 9 to 4 in favor of OVU. Trevecca has led by as many as 11. That came with 12:17 to go in the first half. So now to the line is Lawrence, where he has scored 21 of their 32. He misses there. He is now 7 of 10 from the foul line. He's hit 6 of 7 from the field and is 2 of 2 from 3. He misses there. Slay Chole with the rebound for the Trojans. Byron Sanford back in, gets it to Elliott. Trojans will have a week off here. There's a steal by Lawrence. Lawrence up ahead, puts it up, no good, but he's fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two. That looked like a good, clean play by Taylor Clay, but he gets whistled for the foul. They say he got him on the elbow. It looked like he had just forced a really tough shot. That is Clay's second. Each team in the two-foul limit now with 10 or more fouls. 38-32, Lawrence sets. He just missed two in a row. He hits the first one here, though. That is his 12th free throw attempt here in the first half. Now back to the line, Lawrence. No good. It's tipped out right to him, though. They get it underneath. Shot put up. And it is good by Smelzer. That's his first two, and it's 38-35, a three-point Trojan lead. Chole to Clay. Out top, Elliott. Need a good shot here. Sanford looks in for Miles. Sanford now puts it on the floor. Penetrates, kicks out. Clay for three. Good. Taylor Clay with his first tray of the game. He's got 5 first-half points, and the Trojans lead by 6 again, 41-35. Lawrence for three, trying to answer. Short rebound. McDonald had it, then Sanford tipped it away, and then OVU is able to save it back in. That was Dombrowskis throwing it back. Underneath, Lawrence, reverse layup is good, and the foul, he'll go to the line. Foul is on Slay Chole. Chris Renfro preparing to come in for the Trojans. He will. Lawrence, free throw is good. He completes the three-point play. 41. 38. Underneath. Pass goes to Wooder. Turns into the lane. Goes up, shoots. He did not hit, but he is fouled. And he'll shoot two at the line. Dombrowskis with the foul, his second. Woodard gets two more shots at the foul line. He is 3 of 4 here in the first half from the free throw line. Free throw is up and good. He hits. He'll get another. Woodard. In and out. Rebound comes to OVU. 42-38, 4-point advantage. Right side with the ball. Back into the game is Parker. They hand it off to Lawrence. He is certainly the person they go to. Underneath the pass into Smelzer. He backs down, shoots over Chole. No good. Chole blocked that one. Now Sanford in transition. Goes up, and it's good. And he's fouled. He'll go to the line. Byron Sanford. Five for Sanford from the line. He has got 15 in the game. The foul is whistled against, I believe that's number 32. It's against McDonald. It's his second. 45-38 as he hits the free throw. Up and no good. So Sanford piloted on for the Trojans in the first half. We do have a foul now against the Trojans. Christopher Elliott. And more free throws. The first is up and no good. Short. Dombroskis. Missed the first one. That's his first attempt of the game from the foul line. Has not even shot from the field, but he hits there on the second one. 45-39. 5:42 to play in the half. Chole looks under for Woodard. Passes out top to Renfro. Now Sanford. Sanford out top. Chole. Just inside the three-point line. No good. Rebound. Elliott. Elliott goes back up. His shot is off the glass. No good. Chole tips it. And now Elliott gets pulled to the floor. No call. Chole goes up. And somehow the officials just let that go. They finally do call a foul against OVU's Gerald McDonald, Ohio Valley. And that is his third foul here in the first half. Chole to the line. 6'8", sophomore out of South Sudan. Hits the free throw, his first point of the game. He is 67% on the year from the line, 4 of 6 coming in. He'll get another one. It is on the way, and it's good. Chole with two. Averages 3.1 per appearance. 47-39. Trojans have eased their lead. Back up to 8. McDonald lost the handle. Fighting for it is Elliott. It is still loose and now taken away by Dombroskis. And I think they're going to call a foul against Trevecca. You almost cannot get blocking called anymore. And I understand that. They're trying to create offense. And to some degree, I agree with it. It's gone too far the other way for a few years where defense has had the huge advantage and it just was like a wrestling match out there. So it takes some time for the players and coaches to adjust. But I give the officials credit. They have been consistent this year with it and trying to keep things going. Two free throws. Good by Dombroskis. He is now 3 of 4 from the line here in the first half. 47-40. Trojans lead by 7. Sanford kicks it back out. They swing it around. There's Elliott. Elliott drives. Hop step. Goes up. Got it blocked. It's going to go out of bounds. It'll be Trevecca basketball leading by 7. Sanford, the leading scorer for the Trojans, was 16-25 now for Lawrence to lead the Scots in scoring. Woodard with the ball. They're the 2 of 3 in double figures. Woodard with 10 is the other one. Sanford kicks out. Renfro dribble and then a shot. It is no good off the mark. Rebound comes away to Ohio Valley. They push it up the floor. Nice catch in transition by Parker. Parker now gets it to Lawrence in the right corner. Woodard is on him. Pass out to Parker. Parker drives. Parker hangs. Lays it up. No good. Chole with the rebound. And then Chole is fouled. I'm going to call that on Dombroskis. And it'll be more free throws. They have checked into the game. Tyler Davis out of Marietta, Ohio. Transferred in from Rio Grande University. 6'1 junior. And so Chole goes to the line. Chole. Hit. Chole is 3 for 3 from the foul line. Right at his average. 48-40. And Chole hits again. Dombroskis was whistled for his third. 49-40, Trojans by 9. Davis brings it up. Gets it right side to Lawrence. Lawrence drives and draws the foul. It's going to be whistled against Slay Choll. His second. 4-12. We'll get the under 4 media timeout here in a moment. Lawrence, free throw is good. He has shot 15 free throws here in the first half. He is at 10 of them. Make that 10 of 16, but they get the rebound, and putting it back up and in is Smelzer. So Lawrence misses the free throw, but they get two more out of it, and it's a 6-point game with 4 minutes to play in the half. 49-43, left side Elliott. Now to Renfro, right side Sanford, looking in, drives now down the baseline, finds room, uses the body, puts it up, comes off the rim, Choll gets it, can't get it to go in, and he'll go to the line and shoot two after this media timeout. 3:47 to play in the half. Trojans lead it 49-43. Forty-9-43. Slay Choll at the line for the Trojans. Choll is 4-for-4 here in the first half from the line. He is 5-for-5 now. Fifty to 43 with 3:47 to play. Choll hits again. He is perfect at the line. 6-for-6. Here in the first half, he has doubled up his season average of 3.1 points per game. Lawrence lost the handle. Choll tips it over to Clay. Mack Walden. Walden goes up to Sanford, who lays it in. Great play by Mack Walden and Sanford and Choll. Trojans up by 10 with 3:23 to go in the half now. Parker into the right side of the lane. Kicks it out to Davis. Now the pass is deflected in the air. It'll be OVU basketball with 3:16 to play and 20 on the shot clock. Elliott, Choll, Sanford, Walden, and Renfro out there for the Trojans. Pass goes deep to Lawrence. Lawrence being harassed. They get it left side. Davis drives. His shot is no good. The ball is taken away by Smelzer. Now Davis goes up. Shot no good. Put back up and in by Parker. They got a lot of rebound opportunities on that one. 53-45, 2:51 to play. Choll catches. Choll turns, shoots, and hits. Choll now with 8 here in the first half. 2:39 to play, 55-45. Pass goes inside. Smelzer falls down. That's a travel. Choll kind of stepped out of the way, and it was a travel. So the Trojans get the ball. Slay Choll playing a terrific first half for the Trojans. Now he kind of, Pat smells her as they walk back down the floor. Good sportsmanship by both. Three, no good. Almost stolen away by Sanford. Lawrence has it. He's going to bring it up all the way. Left of the lane, goes up, and he is going to be called for the charge. I can't believe I actually saw a charge called in a college basketball game this year. Haven't seen many. That's going to be the first whistle against Lawrence. 55-45. Right side, Elliott with the ball. Lays it up, no good. Comes off the iron, rebound taken away by Ohio Valley. Mike Snell, the coach for OVU, spending more time arguing with the Trevecca fans behind him about whether that was a good call or not. We do have seats right behind him there. It's been a crazy first half in the SEC championship game. It is 28-27 in favor of Auburn over Missouri. To the line, free throw is on the way, and good by Smelzer. ...55-46, 2:06 on the first half clock. Second one is good by Smelzer. 55-47. Trojans have slowed down Lawrence, and that's admitting he's got 26 in the first half. Renfro puts it up, and good. Renfro extends the Trojan lead back to 10 again. Lawrence had 25 with about 7-8 minutes to go in the half, and the Trojans have been able to clamp down on him a little bit since then, but he's going to the line again. He has shot 16 free throws in the first half and hit 10 of them. And he goes back to the line again. That one is good. Saquon Lawrence is at the line. Having to take over another player's free throws. He misses that one. ...57-48. He now has 27 points, does Lawrence. He's the real deal. Walden gets it back to Renfro. Renfro left side to Sanford. Underneath, Pond. Pond back to Walden, ball fakes. And he is fouled, and he'll shoot two. So Walden goes to the line for the first time. He's 0 for 2 from the line on the year. Has not scored this season. Trojans as a team shooting 67% from the foul line on the year. And in the first half, 76% as a team. Walden hits there. That is his first point of the season. He transfers in from Palm Beach Atlantic. The second one is good as well. Wonderful kid. Glad to have him on campus here. And he's just worked his way into getting more minutes. He's out of Versailles, Kentucky, 6'3", sophomore guard out of Christian Academy of Louisville. He's got two out of the Trojans, 59. That one tipped by the rim. They'll wave it off. Trojans will get the ball with a minute 12 to go. 59-48, Trojans lead by 11. And we've got a timeout. We'll take one as well. Trojans lead it by 11.
I've always been told that with a good education and hard work, you can go far in life. And I believe that. And so that's why I got my master's at Trevecca. I've always dreamed of counseling with military families, and Trevecca is one of two programs that are accredited for the MFT program. I'm entering my PhD now in clinical counseling, and already I'm seeing that hard work pay off.
Write your own story at Trevecca Nazarene University. Visit tnustarthere.org for more information.
Welcome back, Greg Ruff and Matt Deal. Lucas and Martin across the way, our interns from the Czech Republic with us as well. Walden gets it to Renfro. Renfro with the ball gets it over to Walden. Walden drives right of the lane. It goes up, no good, but he draws a foul, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Again to the line, number 52, Mac Walden.
Walden, 2 for 2 from the foul line, and gets a couple of more. He'll hit there. He goes back to the line. Free throw is on the way, and good. Walden, 4 for 4 from the line. Has 4, and it's 61-48. Parker gets it to Davis. Underneath. Goes up, Smelter, no good. Rebound, Walden. Walden gets it up ahead to Sanford. Sanford with the ball. Backs it out of there. Gets it to Renfro. Sanford just holding it. Shot clock is on. About a 3-second differential. Into the lane. Just inside the foul line. No good. Rebound. Comes away. And they're going to call a foul on Renfro. Renfro whistled for his second.
Two shots for the Fighting Scouts, number 12, Austin Parker.
61-48 is the score. And Parker, with 2.5 seconds to go in the half, will go to the line. He is 1 for 2, and he hits there. It is good. ...61-49. Free throw is on the way, and good. Parker, 3 for 4. It's 61-50. 11-point lead. Sanford looks good, but it was off the line, and he misses. Trojans go into the half, leading by 11. They led by as many as 13. We'll take a pause. When we come back, it'll be Clayton Kaufman talking with Gary Vanatta, the women's basketball coach here at halftime.
That was not good at all.
It's halftime from the Trojan Fieldhouse. The men's team on top of Ohio Valley, 61-50. Clayton Coffin joined now by head women's basketball coach Gary Van Atta. Coach, we parlayed what we did in the second half against Sandler National pretty much throughout the entire game earlier against Ohio Valley, winning 99-58. And Haley Felker sets a modern-day Trevecca record, hitting her first 5 3-point attempts. And she has been on fire these last three games. How pleased are you to see that from Haley, who's really just got a nice shooting stroke, and the shots are dropping for her right now?
She's really playing well right now. Haley's always been a great shooter, you know, but she's worked hard on the other parts of her game. That's what makes her such a complete player. And really excited about all the things she does. If you look at her stat line, it's, you know, four steals, you know, two block shots.
That one down low, yeah, on that first block was, are you kidding me? But.
And then, you know, three assists, no turnovers. I mean, she's just playing lights out right now. And it was unfortunate that she got injured early on, or she'd have been starting for us all year long. But she's just a really good player. And she shows exactly what happens when you're unselfish. You take good shots. And you work hard to improve the other parts of your game, which is what she's done.
You talk about good shots. We are shooting within the offense. For the open pass, we are shooting. You know, once the pass comes, we're there, we're shooting. And offensively, we're leading the conference in scoring. Two big wins to start. How pleased are you to come in? Two GMAC wins to start the year, and that's going to hopefully propel us starting in January.
Well, you hope so, but yeah, I'm tickled to death. Obviously, I couldn't ask for anything better than to start off 2-0 in the conference. And I'm really pleased with the girls about how far we've come from what we learned in Denver, you know, the tournament. It seems like every time we come back from someplace like that, we just get more focused. And they are, and they're ready for conference play. And I've been coaching a long time, Clayton. I really have. Been here 9 years, but, I mean, I really have been coaching a long time. I've never had a team start the way this team started tonight.
Nine of 11 to start, and 4 for 4 from downtown.
Yeah, but even that, just 29-0, actually, defensively, you shut the other team out. It was just phenomenal. I was really, really proud of them. They set the pace, and from there, that point on, they never stopped.
You're talking about the defensive performance. You know, I thought going into the year, our guards would be the difference early on, and we're seeing Sarah Raby underneath, Kylie White, back-to-back double-digit scoring efforts. When our, we've got some freshmen and sophomores in the low post, but as each game progresses, they are going to get better, and that's just going to add to an already good starting guard lineup that we have. What does that make you feel like, knowing that we're going to have some progression from our low posts, hopefully throughout the rest of the year?
Man, I tell you what, it's exciting, you know, because that was our biggest concern, obviously. I told you we were young inside. We have really only returned one returning player from inside, and that was Anna Mitchell. And Britt played the combination spot, played inside and outside, but mostly played outside. So just the movement and the development of Sarah Raby to put Sarah in at the starting line and move Britt out to face the basket, which makes it more comfortable for her too. And Sarah's toughness has been really good. But, you know, what can you say, like I said, about Kylie? She's been lights out off the bench, averaging 14 points the last two games, 15 on Thursday and 13 tonight. And in limited play, she's averaging more than a point a minute, you know. And if she didn't have a stress fracture,
right,
she'd be playing more minutes than that. So we're trying to keep her healthy until after Christmas, when she should be back at full strength. So I'm proud of all the girls right now. You know, Nick's the last bunch that went in right there, you know, the last 4 or 5 minutes or so.
A lot of youth. Hey, I said it on me. You had Morgan Long, Keonda Fields, Anna Kirtner. Who else was out there?
Megan
Kilburn, and one more.
Marissa.
That would have been Marissa. Yeah. Those girls have never played together before, let alone seen a lot of college basketball action.
And the only sophomores out there,
didn't play much last year. Yes. Anna.
And Marissa. Marissa's considered a sophomore as well,
sure,
because she's transferring. And Keonda, who was a redshirt sophomore, I guess, as well. So, you know, they didn't have much experience, but get them out there, get a chance to play. And there were some turnovers, got a little sloppy, but I was telling them, they were trying to do what I'd asked them to do. If you're going to make a mistake, I'd rather you make that kind of a mistake than a mistake when you're doing your own thing. So I'm pleased with that. Rebounding, I was tickled to death with. Points in the paint. Two nights in a row now, we've had about 100-30 points in the paint. We were 54 the first night. We're 46 tonight. That's 100 points. Outscore our opponent by you know, 70 in the paint over two games is phenomenal.
Coach, we've got three games until the new year. We've got University of Indianapolis, who we saw last year, and not the outcome we wanted per a big second half, some three-point shooting in that second half last year up in Indianapolis. And then we'll go up to Bellarmine and play Bellarmine in Southern Indiana. Let's start with UIndy. They come here in 11 days, and I know the girls are going to want to have a better showing than what they did last year at Indianapolis. What's it going to take for us to do that?
That's a great question. You know, last year we really got it there and just were in awe, honestly. They were big and huge and physical. And
including their coach.
They were the number one team in the nation at that point, and they played like it, you know. And every time they came off the bench with somebody else, you know, their leading scorer wound up coming off the bench just jacking like six threes in a row in the second half down there. So we expect that, and we schedule it that way. Southern Indiana is one of the top teams in the country. Bellarmine is receiving votes and doing better, and they're all in that Great Lakes Valley. So they're going to be tough for us. You know, I'm glad we're playing Indiana at home. Hopefully we'll be focused against them and come out with a better effort. And right now we just got to get through this the exams and let them focus on that, and we'll have some practices. It'll be more energy than thinking, so they can just go out there and not have anything to worry about. And then give them the weekend off and then come back ready for two hard practices to get ready for Indy, and then close out our pre-Christmas schedule. It's going to be fun.
Well, I can't wait to be with you, Coach, and thank you for your time, and congrats on the win today.
Appreciate that, and we really want the best to Rachel Bollinger, our senior, who's out with a concussion, and we thought maybe we had it licked, and then she's had a few more symptoms pop up, and so we just want her to have a speedy recovery, and one another we're praying for.
Well, I'm sure we're going to see her in 11 days fresh and out there hustling as she usually does. Coach, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
That was head women's basketball coach Gary Venata. The Trojans defeat Ohio Valley in that first game, 99-58. We've got about 5 minutes to go until the start of the second half between Trevecca and Ohio Valley on the men's side, 61-50, TNU in that one. Byron Sanford leading the Trojans in that first half. We're going to take a timeout, and we'll come back right after this.
I've always been told that with a good education and hard work, you can go far in life. And I believe that. And so that's why I got my master's at Trevecca. I've always dreamed of counseling with military families, and Trevecca is one of two programs that are accredited for the MFT program. I'm entering my PhD now in clinical counseling, and already I'm seeing that hard work pay off.
Write your own story at Trevecca Nazarene University. Visit tnustarthere.org for more information.
Welcome back. Greg Ruff with you. Trojans lead 61-50 at the half. We're a couple of minutes away from second half action. Saquon Lawrence led Ohio Valley in scoring in the first half. He had 27 points, one assist, seven rebounds, one steal in the first half of play. He was 7 of 9 from the field, 2 of 3 from 3, 11 of 18 from the foul line. No other players for the Scots finished in double figures, though 7 points for Smelzer to go along with 6 rebounds. He was a significant factor in the first half. He also had 2 blocks, all of their blocks, in the first half. They didn't have anybody with more than 1 assist. They only had 4 as a team and 13 turnovers. They out-rebounded Trevecca 20-16 in the half. Austin Parker was 3 of 4 from the foul line, had 5 points. Everybody else with 1 or 2 points for the Scots in the first half. They shot 13 of 26, 50%, 3 of 6 from 3, 50%, and 21 of 31 from the foul line for 67% in the first half. For the Trojans, 2 in double figures. Byron Sanford had 18 first-half points, 6 of 9 from the field, 0 of 1 from 3, 6 of 8 from the foul line. He had 3 rebounds, 2 assists, and 2 steals. 10 points for David Woodard, 3 of 3 from the field, 4 of 6 from the line, 2 rebounds, an assist, and a steal. 8 points also, along with 5 rebounds for Slade Chole. He had a block. 2 steals for Christopher Elliott, who had 3 points and a rebound, was 3 of 4 from the line. 5 rebounds, again, for Chole to second. He was 6 of 6 from the foul line, 1 of 2 from the field. As a team, the Trojans had 5 turnovers, 5 assists, 3 blocks, and 6 steals. 18 of 32 from the field for the Trojans, 56%. 2 of 6 from three-point range, 33%. And 79% from the foul line, 23 of 39. Trojans outscored OVU 30-20 on points scored in the paint, 16-5 in points scored off turnovers. Second chance points went to OVU 14-8. Fast break points 8-0 in favor of the Trojans. Bench scoring 21-15 in favor of the Trojans, who lead it 61-50 at the half. Second half action, Ohio Valley in blue with white numerals and red trim. Start the second half with the ball. Working it up top, and they get it inside. Macon Jr.'s loose ball ends up in the hands of Clay for the Trojans. He stops and pops the three. It is in and out. No good. Ball knocked loose, but maintaining possession is Vittens for OVU. Behind the back dribble by Macon Jr. that he drives, puts it up, no good. Rebound, Aaron Turner for the Trojans. He outlets to Sanford. Sanford brings it up. Kick out. Woodard drives from the left wing off the glass, and it is good. David Woodard with the basket. He now has 12. Trojans lead it by 13. Drive and a put-up by Macon Jr. No good. Rebound is out of bounds. It'll be off of Trevecca, and the Scots will maintain possession. The Scots 1-7 on the year. 1-2 at home, 0-4 on the road, 0-1 in neutral site. Trojans 3-6, 3-2 at home, 0-3 on the road, and 0-1 in neutral site games. OVU inbounds underneath the basket, almost got away, but saving it was Vietens, and now he gets it back into the paint. Driving, turns, puts it up. He got fouled by Miles, and Miles has picked up his third foul. Vietens with his first, Miles with his third foul. Vietens, Artus Vietens with his first free throw. It is no good. He had 2 first half points and is 68% on the year, 15 of 22 coming in from the line, and he hits there. So 1 for 2 on that trip. Sanford brings the ball up. Has it on the left side. Looks for Miles. He's playing with 3. Trojans with 1 foul here in the first half. Lost the ball, did Miles. And then stolen back by Sanford, and then he is fouled by Austin Parker. That'll be his second. into Miles. Miles in the baseline trap. They kick it out. There's a three by Clay. It is no good. Put back up and in by Aaron Turner. What a great rebound follow and finish by Aaron Turner. Puts the Trojans up by 14. Three on the way. Good. Two-pointer by Macon Jr. 65-53. 18-17 to play. And we got a whistle away from the ball. It's going to be called against Ohio Valley. Left side Woodard. Underneath the Miles. Miles puts it up and in. Good job by Miles to stay with it. Miles gets the basket. Three on the way, and it is good from in the corner by Macon Jr. That is a three. The first one was not. Woodard inside Miles. Miles dunks it home. Miles now with eight in the game. Lawrence drives, and they're going to say a foul on the floor on Woodard. Woodard whistled for his second. So now Macon Jr. to inbound. Does. Gets it to Dombroskis. He drives, lays it up and in. Nice drive. And it's 69-58, 17 minutes to play in the game. Samford dribbles, gets it back to Turner. Now Woodard looking in. Now out top. Play. Samford. Samford looks inside. Bounce pass. That's Turner. Turner finds room, puts up the shot, no good. Good defense by Dombroskis. Pushing it up the floor, and a foul is going to be called. That's going to be against Jordan Miles, and I believe that is four on him. I have it being four, but it may be three. Free throw on the way is no good by Macon. Misses that one. 66% on the year, 33 of 50 coming in. And so Miles leaves with three fouls. Can't always trust the broadcaster's unofficial stats. And you could not there because I had him with four, and I'm glad I was wrong. Macon Jr. with the second free throw is good. He's got 6 points all here in the second half. 69-59, Trojans by 10. Jordan Bedwell in for Jordan Miles. Samford to Turner. Turner at the elbow, left side, no good. Rebound, Macon Jr. He pushes it up the floor. Stops and pops the three, it is no good. Rebound is saved in. It goes to Parker. Now they throw it back in the corner. Parker drives, puts it up. He draws the, it's gonna be offensive on him. Parker whistled for his third. ...69-59 with 16:04 to play. Three fouls for each team this half. Samford with the ball. And a dunk by Jordan Bedwell. Bedwell with four. There's a runner stolen away by Samford. Two shots is the call. Samford And we've got a media timeout. 15:42 to play in the basketball game. Trojans lead it 71-59.
Hi, I'm Ryan Albajava at TNU. I'd like to tell you a little bit about some of our drinks here at the shop. Lattes, mochas, but I want to tell you a little bit more specifically about a particular brewing method called a pour over. What we do is we grind the beans fresh, we place them inside one of these cups here, put a filter, place the beans inside that, use really hot water, pour it over, use a little bit more coffee than what you would normally think to use. We kind of work that coffee as it's going through, and it makes a real bold, very smooth cup of coffee. If you would like to experience that cup of coffee, we are in the Center for Leadership Calling and Service. Or if you'd like to call us and get more information, our phone number is 248-1716. The foul I had on Jordan Miles apparently was on Aaron Turner earlier. To the foul line, free throw is up and good. No good by Macon Jr. He is 1-for-3 from the line. 66% on the year, averaging 13.6 points per game. Did not score in the first half. He hits there and is 2-for-4 from the line. He now has 7. All here in the second half. Turner. Play. Trojans by 11. 15:30 to play. Left side. Sanford. Trojans with some motion here. Trying to get the shot. Bedwell. Skip pass out to Woodard. Woodard with 12 to shoot. Woodard. Nice pass into Sanford. Sanford stops from 10. Got blocked. Lawrence with the ball. He's going to try to take it all the way up, but it's knocked away by Sanford. Now Jordan Bedwell has it and gets it back to Sanford. Trojans with an opportunity. 15:04 to play. Foul's going to be whistled on Smelzer. That's their fourth, each team with 4 fouls now. And it is his second. Inbound to Clay in the corner for 3. It's good. Taylor Clay. Eight for Clay. Driving. Smells it. Nice pass, but a block by Turner. Stifles him for just a moment, but staying with it was Parker, and Parker gets the basket. He got blocked, but the ball ended up back in his hands. Turner now on the other end, and we got a foul called against Smelzer. His third. And it'll be 2 shots for Aaron Turner. Turner with 5 in the game, 62% from the line on the year, 10 of 16 coming in. This will be his first trip to the foul line tonight. He's a junior out of Houston, Texas. Hits there. He now has 6. He averages 6 per game, 4.3 rebounds. Has 12 assists, a block, and 4 steals. Transferred in with David Woodard out of Navarro Community College. Turner hits. He's got 7. The Trojan lead is 14. Driving with it. Parker underneath. New into the game, Bettinger. His first 2. Averages a point, a little over a point, and a little over a rebound a game. Gets 2 after immediately coming in the game. Clay fakes on the 3. Trojans by 12. Turner. Looks like a 2-3 zone. Woodard finds room, dumps to Bedwell. Bedwell
Might have had that one altered. I'm not sure. He missed it. Lawrence gets it down. Driving with it is Parker. His shot is up and good. Parker with six from the field. Has nine total with three free throws. 76-66. Trojans by 10. Woodard, right side, Clay. Clay dribbles with it now to Turner. Turner back to Clay in the right corner, and we got a travel on Clay. 76-66. Saquon Lawrence has not scored here in the second half after putting up 27 first half points. Dribbling through traffic and driving with it and putting the shot up, drawing the foul. After the miss is Jerry Macon Jr. And he'll go to the line to shoot a pair. The foul against Jordan Bedwell, his third. Each team now with five team fouls here in the second half. Free throw is up. Front iron, a little glass, a little more iron, and dropping through. And now Macon is 3 for 5 from the line in the game. Has 8 points all here in the second half. Did not score in the first. Hits again. He's a 5'10 junior guard out of Southfield, Michigan, and transferred from Lipscomb University right here in Nashville. Left side, Woodard. Woodard drives, finds room in the paint, and lays it in. Woodard with 14. Trojans lead it by 10 again after being cut to single digits. Lawrence with the ball. Yet to score in the second half. Woodard is all over him, and he's going to get whistled for the foul. That's a tough call on Woodard. His third. Sixth team foul against the Trojans, so it'll be 1-1 the rest of the way. 12:48 to play. Lawrence drives. Has it knocked away by Woodard. Loose ball, Clay. Clay can't get it back to Woodard. He was trapped, but Trojans will defense in the half court. Seventy-eight, 68, 12:39 to play. Inbound pass and drawing a foul. And shooting two is Dombroskis. That is four on Bedwell. Dombroskis to the line. His free throw is on the way and good. Dombroskis missed the free throw, but rebound taken away by OVU. Jumper put up and no good. Tipped up, no good. Rebound comes away to the Trojans. 78-69, 12:25 to play. Clay with the ball. Gets it to Elliott. Christopher Elliott back into the game. Woodard spinning, has it knocked loose. Gets it back, and then it's knocked out of bounds. It'll be OVU basketball. Got a travel called against OVU. 78-69, almost to the under 12 timeout. 78-69. Sanford to Elliott. Woodard. Now Clay. Sanford back to Clay. Ball fakes. Passes to Elliott. Elliott drives, and it's going to be called for the travel. And we've got the media timeout. 11:49 to play. Trojans by 9 here at the Trojan Fieldhouse.
Someone once told me that you can lose everything you have but your education. Because of Trevecca, I'm just a few months away from getting my MHR degree. Being a mom and going back to school has not been easy, but Trevecca made it easy with the best program and the best schedule that fits my life. And I know that if I can do this, anybody can do this.
Inspire your future at Trevecca Nazarene University. Visit tnustarthere.org for more information.
I've already had my associate's degree. It worked for me, but I noticed a point in my life where I wanted more. I wanted to attain those things that I needed to get me where I wanted to be in life. Going back to school, I thought I had to take online classes or I had to commute, but Trevecca had a satellite campus right here in town, and thanks to Trevecca, I'm finding out that I'm able to do this.
Finish your degree at Trevecca Nazarene University. Visit tnustarthere.org for more information.
Trojans shooting 55% from the field, 25 of 45, 3 of 8 from three-point range, 37%, and 80% from the line, 25 of 30. OVU out-rebounding the Trojans 29-19. Very rarely this year have the Trojans been out-rebounded, in particular by this large of a margin. OVU, though, has turned the ball over 19 times to Trevecca's 10. That kind of balances that out. OVU shooting 51%. 19 of 37, got a travel called against Sinakis. Four of eight from three-point range for the Scots. Free throws, they are at 65%, 27 of 41. Clay with the ball for the Trojans. That's it from Woodard. Play back to Woodard. Left side, Elliott in the corner, driving with it. Sanford, and he is mauled and will shoot. No, he will not shoot, I do not believe. I think it'll be an inbound situation. That is the sixth. Bettinger with his first foul. 78-69, Trojans by nine, and the ball. Sanford goes deep. Elliott, the pass to him is deflected, and then they're going to call a foul on OVU, Jerry Macon Jr., and I'm going to be honest with you, that was the wrong call. Christopher Elliott grabbed him, but we're not going to complain about it. We're going to let it go. And it'll be 1-1 for Christopher Elliott. Elliott was actually holding him to keep him from going for the ball instead of the other way around. Elliott to the line, hits the front end, so he'll get the bonus. He has now hit 4 of 5 from the line. All of his scoring coming from the charity stripe. A 77% shooter on the year from the stripe. Coming in, he's 27 of 35. And now he hits again. 5 of 6 for Elliott at the free throw line. 80-69, Trojans back up by 11 with 11-11 to play. Lawrence, who has been held in check here in the second half. Just 27 points, no points in the second half, but 27 in the first half. A three by Gerald McDonald. He now has 8, and the Trojan lead is 8 at 80-72. Woodard back to Elliott, facing this 2-3 zone. Clay back to Elliott. Clay in the corner. Sanford trying to drive. Gets his man in the air. Out to Clay for 3. Good. Taylor Clay drills his third three-pointer of the game. He now has 11. 83-72. Trojans come up with the steal. Elliott up ahead, Sanford. Sanford takes it, lays it in. Sanford with his first two of the second half. He now has 20 points in the game. He had 18 in the first half. They get the ball to McDonald, now back out to Lawrence. Again, who had 27 in the first half, and he has 27 still. Driving, runner is up, no good. Rebound taken away by Clay. That would tell you, by the way, that the Trojans have made adjustments, and it has worked as they have extended their lead now to 13 again. And we'll get free throws down on the other into the court. Arturs. Beatons will come in to the game. And it will be Taylor Clay at the foul line. The foul was whistled against Bettinger, his second. Clay misses the front end of the 1-1. He is 0 for 2 from the line, and now a travel called against Lawrence. I thought we were looking at a 50-point game out of Lawrence, but, and rightfully so, he had 27 at the half. But the Trojans about 7-8 minute range, somewhere there in the first half, really clamped down on him and held him. He had 25 early in that first half. Sanford again with another rebound on a miss. He just finds the ball, doesn't he? Three by Clay is good.
From David Woodard.
Woodard with the assist. The rebound, Sanford. Lawrence drives, and the ball is out of bounds. It'll be OVU basketball. Trojans lead it by 16, their largest lead of the game. 88-72, 9:19 to play in the game. Inbound to Lawrence. Lawrence goes right up. He's fouled, and he'll get a chance to get his first points of the second half. Woodard with four now. Jordan Miles has four. Woodard has four. And Bedwell has four. Free throw by Lawrence is good. And he'll get one more. Lawrence has shot 19 free throws now. Is it 12 of them? Make it 13 of 20. He now has 29 points to go along with 9 rebounds. Sanford gets it to Elliott. Trojans by 14. 88-74, 9 minutes to play in the game. Woodard gets it to Elliott. Nice pass to Bedwell, who dunks. Bedwell with his second dunk. He now has 6 points, 4 here in the second half of play. McDonald spots up for a 3. In and out, tipped, ball is taken down. Sanford with a steal, tipped it to himself. He'll take it, lays it up high, and it goes in off the glass. Byron Sanford with 22, and the Trojans lead again by 16, 92-74, 8:29 to play. And we've got a foul called against OVU, a legal screen called on Sinakis. His third. They're going to get Dombroskis in. They also checked in, I believe, during that timeout, Smelzer. And they're still in the 2-3 zone. Out top of the zone, Parker and McDonald. Chris Renfro into the game for the Trojans. Passes it right side to Renfro. Does Elliott. Now to Clay, working against that zone again. Double team, gets it to Sanford. Sanford kicks it out. Elliott drives from the left wing. Runner is up and good by Christopher Elliott. That is his first field goal of the game. He has 7 points, 5 of 6 from the line. Runner by McDonald is rattling home. A little runner in the paint. Got enough of the inside of the rim to fall through. Sanford brings the ball up, 94-76. Renfro with the ball. Passes to Clay. Left side. Now back to Clay from Sanford. Elliott in the corner. Renfro out to Clay. Sanford. Dumps it down, out in the corner. Three by Elliott, no good. Saved by Bedwell. New 35 for the Trojans. Sanford holds it. 7:06 to play. Sanford stops, got fouled, or is it going to be, it's going to be a travel, and we'll get the media timeout. OVU will have the ball. They're down by 18, 94-76. with 7:05 to play here at the Fieldhouse. Trojans 58% from the field now, 31 of 53, 5 of 12 from three-point range, 79% from the line, 27 of 34, 24 turnovers now for OVU. Trebek has turned the ball over just 11 times. Trojans have led by as many as 20. It came at the 8:05 mark. There's a shot put up and a rebound by Bedwell. Trojans lead it by 18 now. Elliott gets it back from Clay. Now Renfro, ball fakes on a three into Bedwell. Bedwell turns with the hook and it's in and out. Went halfway down and then came out. Up ahead, they get it to Lawrence. Lawrence, ball fakes on the three, drives, slashes, good. Oh, it comes off the rim. Used the glass and everything and it still came off the rim for Lawrence. Renfro dribbles out of all kinds of traffic. Skip in the corner. Elliott drives to the paint. Puts it up and in. What a beautiful play by Renfro and Christopher Elliott. Beautiful play. That looked like an old-time Julius Erving palming of the ball. Trojans up ahead. Renfro lays it up and in. And a timeout called as this one is getting away from the Scots. Trojans lead it by 22 with 6:04 to play, 98-76. 60. '98-76 with 6 minutes to play in the game. Lawrence with the ball. Drives. Shoots it from 15. It's good. Lawrence now with 31. 98-78. 5:44 to play. There's Clay with the ball. Clay gets it to Renfro. Renfro passes left side to Clay. Clay looks in. They clear out for him. He goes up. It is blocked. Rebound Bedwell. Bedwell puts it up and in. And he's fouled. He'll go to the line. Jordan Bedwell having a terrific second half. The foul is whistled against Smelzer, and that's four on him. And so Bedwell goes to the line. Bedwell bends and sends it in. Bedwell now with 9. 7 of those here in the second half. Turn and spin by Smelzer, no good. Lawrence fighting for it, Smelzer fighting for it, and somehow they call a foul and all that. It's going to be against Jordan Bedwell. It's going to be his 5th foul. So he fouls out with 9. And he'll come out of there. Jordan Miles will check in for Jordan Bedwell, who played a long time with 4 fouls. And played well with 4 fouls. And kind of got a cheapie there, as there was all kinds of arms up there. Could have been on really any one of about 4 players, a couple from each side. It's going to be 2 shots for Lawrence. He hits the first, and it's good. Check that. That was a 1-1, I guess. He hits nonetheless. Second one is good for Lawrence. Saquon Lawrence has had a heck of a game. 33 points, I believe, now. He's 15 of 22 from the foul line, 8 of 11 from the field, 2 of 3 from 3. Elliott in the paint, Trojans leading 101 to 80. Ball goes out of bounds. Up here with the ball is Macon Jr. Puts it up off the glass, and it's good. Beautiful play by him. He has had a good second half. 11 points all here in the second half. Renfro drives along the baseline. Bounce pass out to Elliott. He goes into the paint, goes up for the dunk, and it rolls in. And he is going to be called for the offensive foul. Hold on a second. No, they're going to call it. Did they count the basket or not? Yes, basket goes. Wasn't clear on the official's call. Nice aggressive move by Elliott to the hole, and now he completes the 3-point play with the free throw. 104-82. Elliott into double figures with 12 now, and there's a foul called on him on the other end. Tried to draw the charge, but it'll be 2 free throws. That is 3 on Elliott. Both teams well over the 10 foul limit. And Jerry Macon Jr. will go to the line, where he has 11 points all here in the second half, 4 of 6 from the free throw line. It is good by Macon. He's made quite a appearance here in the second half. Again, did not score in the first. Averages 13.6 per game and now has 12, and a point away from being right at his average. Missouri has taken the lead on Auburn, 33-31, point after pending. Bends the knees, does Macon, misses the free throw. Matt Pond into the game, gets the rebound. Pond drives left of the lane, looks to dish it off now. Leans, shoots with the left hand, no good. Ball is taken away by OVU. I believe that was Smelzer with it. Now Lawrence in traffic, takes it, puts it up. Oh, what a beautiful play by Lawrence. He has drawn all kinds of attention from the Trojans, but he has continued to score. He now has 35 points in the contest. 104-85. Into Miles, and a foul is called on Smelzer, and we'll have free throws when we return. 3:49 to play in the game. Trojans lead it 104-85.
Someone once told me that you can lose everything you have but your education. Because of Trevecca, I'm just a few months away from getting my MHR degree. Being a mom and going back to school has not been easy, but Trevecca made it easy with the best program and the best schedule that fits my life. And I know that if I can do this, anybody can do this.
Inspire your future at Trevecca Nazarene University. Visit tnustarthere.org for more information.
I've already had my associate's degree. It worked for me, but I noticed a point in my life where I wanted more. I wanted to attain those things that I needed to get me where I wanted to be in life. Going back to school, I thought I had to take online classes or I had to commute, but Trevecca had a satellite campus right here in town, and thanks to Trevecca, I'm finding out that I'm able to do this.
Finish your degree at Trevecca Nazarene University. Visit tnustarthere.org for more information.
Welcome back. Greg Ruff along with you from the Trojan Fieldhouse on the campus of Trevecca Nazarene University. Trevecca women's basketball team, a winner to go to 2-0 in the conference, 4-5-3, I believe, now overall. Trevecca men leading 104-85 with Jordan Miles at the free throw line.
At the free throw line for the Trojans, number 44, Jordan Miles.
And Miles has 8 points, 4 in each half. He now has 9, 1-for-2 from the foul line this afternoon. 31-41 is what he was coming in to the game from the foul line. He hits there and gets a couple of more. Miles into double figures now. The other way, falling down, drawing a foul, and going to the foul line will be Jerry Macon Jr. Looking at some scores from basketball in the Great Midwest Athletic Conference this afternoon. And a non-conference game, Indianapolis defeated Cedarville 81-51 in women's play. Kentucky Wesleyan defeated Salem International 86-45. And, of course, Trevecca won over Ohio Valley 99-58. To the line, Macon hits. He'll get another one. This one is in and out, no good. Rebound Pond for the Trojans. Trojans pushing it up the floor. Mack walled it into the game. Ball's turned over. Not sure who turned that over. It was a kind of a combination deal there. Maybe a little too hot of a pass and not having the hands out there and ready, but Walden and Miles combined to turn that one over. They get it back, though, as OBU turns it right back over to him. Renfro gets it to Elliott. Trojans break the press. Elliott with a 3-on-2. Miles goes up, hits, and he's fouled, and he'll get the bonus shot at the free throw line. Teams are going to have to adjust to the new way of officiating. I think maybe they're starting to, but just going to have to. 3:24 to play. Jordan Hanner into the game for the Trojans. Miles hits the free throw. It's good. He now has 13. OVU with the ball. Lawrence has it. Dribbles to the left side. Gets through traffic. Kicks it out. They swing it around. And now the three is on the way. It is no good. Tipped up, saved, and it looks like OVU has got it again. That is Parker with it. Parker gets it to Lawrence, and now a foul is called on Christopher Elliott. Elliott with his fourth. Lawrence to the line to shoot two. He has 35 points in the game. His free throw is no good. That is 23 free throws he shot. He is at 15 of them. Has 10 rebounds, so he is at the double-double mark. And adds one more to it, 36. Elliott up to Pond. Pond goes to the hole, no good. Miles is there to finish. Jordan Miles adding to his totals. Three by Miles is off the mark. Just kind of forcing that one up there. Again, the Trevecca women won 99-58. Kentucky Western with it. Ball is loose. OBU had it, and then Hanner takes it, lays it up and in. Hanner with the basket. His first two, averages three per appearance. Up ahead, layup is there by Jerry Macon. Kentucky Wesleyan women won 86-45 as they are 2-0 in the conference. Christopher Elliott's going to inbound the ball. Trojans leading 113. 113-89. 2 minutes to play. There's a steal by Parker. He'll take it. Oh, Walden does the great job of knocking the ball away, and it goes out of bounds off of Parker's knee. Mack Walden with a big play for the Trojans. And then the Trojans throw it away, and OVU gets the ball back. Driving with the ball, laying it up, no good. Rebound comes away to Walden. Walden up ahead, Elliott. Elliott has it, and he is hammered hard. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It's going to be against the opposite number. Austin Parker, his fourth. Auburn leading Missouri now, 38-34. Free throw by Elliott is good. Elliott gets one more. And it is in and out. He's had a good afternoon. Elliott with 13 now. Trojans up 114-89. Most points of the year for the Trojans. There's a shot put up, no good, but going to the line, it's going to be Bettinger. Let's see who that foul is on. It's on Christopher Elliott. He fouls out. He gets the steps from the fans. Gets the steps and sit down from his own fans. You gotta like that. To the line. Bettinger has not been there this afternoon. He'll get one more after missing the first. He has 2 points. He has 1 for 3 now from the foul line on the season. One other game where you don't have a final on the women's side, Central State and Talladega. Free throw is good by Bettinger on the second try. Minute 23 to play. Pond with the ball. Pond dribbles into the lane. Kicks it to Walden from 15. It is short. Rebound goes out of bounds. Three by Walden is no good. Slay Choll into the game. Could not get the rebound. Lawrence the other way. Drives, hangs, lays it in. Lawrence now with 38. Hainer to Choll. Choll up and in. Lawrence three on the way. No good. Rebound taken away by Miles. Miles gets it over to Pond. Pond up ahead. Gets it to Walden. Walden. Skip pass over to Hayner. Over to Walden. Down the corner to Pond. Into Miles. Miles pushed, and he'll go to the line. Bettinger with his third foul. Jordan Miles has been to the line four times tonight. He's hit three and rattles one more home. He now has 16. And the second one is no good. 117 to 92. There's a drive, shot no good. And there'll be free throws for Jerry Macon. That's four on Jordan Miles. Back to the line, free throw is up, and good. For Macon Jr. Shot clock and game clock, well, excuse me, shot clock is off, and the Trojans looking to come away with their fourth victory of the year. They're now 4-2 at home this season, and are now 2-0 in the GMAC. Ohio Valley will drop to 0-2 in the GMAC and 1-8 overall. 117 to 94, Trojans with the victory. We'll pause and come back with some interviews and statistics as you watch the Trojan Sports Network. Welcome back, Greg Ruff along with you, and joining me is Byron Sanford and a sophomore out of Louisville, Kentucky. And you sat out, what, a couple of years after coming out of high school, is that right? One or two years?
2 years.
2 years, you went to University of Kentucky?
Yes, sir.
Well, you know I was born in Lexington, right?
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I was excited to hear that you went there.
But it's all about those Cardinals. So I'm a hometown boy.
That hurts. Did you hear that? Well, we've got a few more championships in Louisville. I do like and respect Louisville over the years with Denny Crum, and now with, of course, Pitino there doing a great job. And I've been known to cheer for Louisville from time to time, too. But tonight, cheering for the Trojans, you did a great job tonight leading this team. 22 points. You also did a lot of other things. Had 18 in the first half. It was an interesting start to the game. Talk about the pace of this one as compared to Salem, in particular, in the first half.
I just really wanted just to get up to a good start for my team to show that we're ready to play and kind of have them feed off me and just get the tempo up a little bit so that way we can push and try to end it out strong because we got to be more consistent in the first and the second half. So I just wanted to be started early and then have them play off me and try to get things going early.
Well, one of the things that was interesting, we have had to face a lot of full court pressure so far this year. And really, you got, for the most part, you guys have really handled that well. Talk about what you think makes you guys good at doing that.
I think moving the ball and just spacing us, we work out on it a lot in practice. So coach works as hard and makes sure that everybody's in the right spot so that way we can get up the floor. Coach talks a lot about two-on-ones and three-on-twos so we can get a layup in transition. So that's what we try to do when teams press us.
All right. You guys get a few days off now and get some finals.
Yes,
I wish you luck with that.
Appreciate it.
I got to write a paper by midnight Sunday to finish my master's, so I understand putting everything else aside. Well, actually, I don't because I still got it. I put it worked on it. But
okay.
I understand you guys got finals and whatnot this week.
Yes,
and it is difficult at times when you're playing at this level in particular to balance the academics and the practice and the demands of travel. And you guys have had a lot of games in the first semester, but now one of the good things about Division II, they mandate no games during the finals.
Right, right.
Does that obviously the academics are pretty important to you as well.
Yes, yes, that's very important. I'm happy to get a little break, get our bodies back ready so we can finish the season out strong with conference play. And also just so everybody can get focused on finals. We're student athletes first, student first, so make sure we're on top of the books and then come back after Christmas and get going again.
Well, have a great week this week. Merry Christmas if I don't see you before you get out of here. But and a break. I know you guys will be back to practice a little bit after finals,
right,
and got a couple more games that you got to hit the road again. But, again, congratulations. Merry Christmas.
I appreciate it. Merry Christmas to you, too.
That's Byron Sanford. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll get you the final statistics here on the Trojan Sports Network. Welcome back. Real quick, we'll go through the final statistics. 117-94, the Trojans with the win. That's Michael Johnson, ladies and gentlemen, by the way. And doing that. Was that an elephant nose? Is that what that was supposed to be? Well, it's gray. It's a gray. I was thinking gray elephant noise. Nose. Nose. I said noise. I'm sorry. Back to the stats. Back to the stats. Merry Christmas to you, by the way, if I don't see you a whole lot between now and then. Aaron Turner for the Trojans with 7 points, 3 rebounds, no assists, was 2 of 5 from the field, 1 of 1 from 3, 2 of 2 from the foul line. 14 points for Taylor Clay. He had a rebound, was 4 of 6 from 3, 5 of 9 from the field, 0 of 1 from the free throw line. Jordan Miles, 16 points, 2 rebounds, 6 of 7 from the field, 4 of 6 from the free throw line. Byron Sanford, 22 points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists, 8 of 12 from the field, 0 of 1 from 3, 6 of 8 from the foul line. David Woodard, 14 points, 2 rebounds, 3 assists, 5 of 5 from the field, 4 of 6 from the free throw line. Matt Pond, 2 points, 2 rebounds, 1 for 5 from the field, 0 of 1 from 3. Jordan Bedwell, 9 points, 7 rebounds, 1 assist, 4 of 6 from the field, 1 of 1 from the free throw line. Christopher Elliott, 3 of 9 from the field, 0 of 1 from 3, 7 of 9 from the line, 13 points, 1 rebound, 3 assists in the game. Jordan Hanner, 2 points and an assist, 1 of 1 from the field. Chris Renfro, 4 points, 1 rebound, 2 of 3 from the field, 0 of 1 from 3. Slade Chole, 10 points, 5 rebounds, 2 of 3 from the field, 6 of 6 from the foul line. Mack Walden, 4 points, 2 rebounds, 1 assist, 0 of 3 from the field, 0 of 2 from 3, 4 of 4 from the foul line. As a team, the Trojans, 57%, 39 of 68. From 3-point range, 5 of 13, 38%. The foul line, 79%, 34 of 43. Trojans closed the rebounding gap late. It was 39-33 in favor of Ohio Valley. OVU turned it over 26 times, Trojans 14 times. And as we look at the largest lead, Trojans led by 26 with 2:34 to play in the basketball game for the lead. OVU from the field, 48%, 26 of 54, 5 of 12 from three-point range, 42%. Free throws, 37 of 55, 67%. And their leading scorer with 38 points and 12 rebounds, a double-double, Saquon Lawrence. 10 of 15 from the field, 2 of 5 from 3, 16 of 24 from the free throw line. Artus Vittens with 3 points, 6 rebounds, 1 of 4 from the field, 0 of 1 from 3, 1 of 2 from the foul line. Macon Jr., 17 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, 4 of 11 from the field, 1 of 2 from 3, 8 of 12 from the foul line. Austin Parker, 9 points, 5 rebounds and assists, 3 of 8 from the field, 0 of 1 from 3, 3 of 4 from the foul line. Dombroskis, 4 points, 3 rebounds, 1 assist, 1 of 1 from the field, 2 of 4 from the free throw line. David Sinakis did not score, had a rebound, 0 of 1 from the field. It was a 3-pointer. Tyler Davis did not score, 0 of 2 from the field. Lance Leslie played, did not score. Galzakis with 2 points, 2 of 2 from the free throw line. McDonald, 11. 1 assist, 4 of 5 from the field, 2 of 2 from 3, 1 of 1 from the foul line. Smelzer, 7 points, 7 rebounds, 2 of 5 from the field, 3 of 4 from the foul line. Bettinger, 3 points and a rebound, 1 of 2 from the field, 1 of 2 from the foul line. And there are your statistics for the game tonight. The Trojans win it by the score of 117-94. The Trojans will head now to a little bit of a break here, as we told you, for the finals that come up this week, and then head into the Christmas break with a trip to Illinois, first on a week from today at the University of Illinois Springfield at 3 o'clock when they'll play Illinois Springfield, and then turn around and have a repeat trip with McKendree on Monday the 16th at 7 o'clock in Lebanon, Illinois. The next home game isn't until January 9th. Trojans will start the new year off with a pair of games at Central State and Cedarville on January 2nd and 4th, and then return home on the 9th and the 11th to the Trojan Fieldhouse to start conference play at home against Alderson Broaddus and Davison Elkins College. So for Matt Deal up top, we appreciate you joining us. And what's that? I guess he's not coming over. We'll go ahead and wrap things up. I want to thank Lucas and Martin with their work on the broadcast, on the camera, and throughout the semester. Our interns from the Czech Republic did a terrific job. Matt Deal, David Klimkowski, and also Clayton Kaufman for all of his assistant, our sports information assistant. We thank you for watching. We'll see you after the Christmas break with men's basketball, women's basketball, back here on the 18th with a free Christmas game here on the Trojan Sports Network.
That was not good at all.